Hey, Ears here, Vapor Trail Archery. Gonna go over a quick review of the Limb Driver Micro Elites, basically how to set it up and get you going right away. Out of the package, you will have obviously the limb driver. You will have your D-loop cord or the activation cord. You will have a arrow holder, a limb pad, and a shelf pad, and also a riser bolt. So the first thing you're gonna do, obviously just like any rest, is use your riser bolt. Mount this guy on there. Make sure it's level. Typically, I'll look at it like this, and you can see it's level across the back. Everything's good there. You know, it's not tilted like this or tilted like that. Get that about to where you want it, and then just snug up the main riser bolt. And then this here's a little set screw that locks. This will lock your rest onto the riser so it won't pivot. You can just tighten that down on there. It's a pointed set screw, so that'll dig into your riser a little bit there and keep it from rotating. Next thing you're gonna wanna do is adjust your square and your center shot. So you want the center shot of the launcher blade to be even with your string, and then you're gonna want the square of the arrow to be perfect, so your arrow is running directly through the burger hole here. To do that on the Micro Elite, you're gonna take, we'll do the elevation first. So the elevation bolt, you just pop that loose just a little bit, and then you can run this here, your knob up or down to wherever you want it. So once you get that to where you want it, obviously you can let go, it's not gonna move. I mean, this will wiggle a little bit, but it's not going to move. Tighten that back down, and that's good to go. Next, obviously, your windage is going to work the same way. So pop your bolt loose just a little bit, and then you can run that left or right to the desired center shot, whichever way you want it. And lock that back in. That's good to go. Usually, the way I recommend setting this up is so when you push your launcher arm down, it doesn't touch the shelf. It'll come really close to touching it, but not completely touch it. There's a lot of different shelves. You know, this one obviously is on a specialist here, and it has a big curve to it. You know, some of your shelves are flat. But you usually don't want, I mean, the best way to set it up is so it isn't touching that shelf. It will come with the shelf pad. Usually I try to get that so when the launcher arm comes down, it contacts the rubber on the shelf pad but doesn't contact the shelf itself. So if you'll see how this one's set up, when you have this on here, the launcher arm will come down and see, you can see it contacts the rubber there, but if the rubber wasn't there, it wouldn't be contacting the shelf. That's typically the best way to set these up. They're actually stopping themselves. The actual shelf of the boat isn't stopping them. So once you get that set up, I mean, that's obviously going to be adjusted with your elevation there. Once you get that set up, the next thing you want to do is obviously tie the activation cord on. This, I already have the limb pad installed. You can take some isopropyl alcohol, just clean that limb tip off a little bit, and that's adhered right on there. The best place to put that on your limb, I get a lot of questions on how far, you know, you want to put it on the axle, you want to put it halfway. Typically what I tell people, the best way to figure that out is if you take your hand, run it up the limb, as soon as you touch your cam there, that's about where you want it. That seems to be the sweet spot on most bows. Now, you can actually adjust when in the shot cycle that the launcher arm will drop by moving it closer to the limb pocket or closer to the limb tip. If you move it closer to the limb pocket, it's going to drop earlier in the shot cycle. If you move it closer to the limb tip, it's going to drop later in the shot cycle. But typically right there is where you want it. Unless you're running into a super fast bow with a short brace height, long feathers, or a long fletching combination that you may be getting a little bit of fletching contact, that's the only time you really want to move it. And then you would want to move it just up the limb a little bit. And when I say a little bit, maybe half the length of one of these limb pads. So the next thing you're going to do is take your cord, and this one I already have cut and everything, but you will just burn the tip down. All right, for your knot on the limb, that's just a basic D-loop knot. I've already got the limb pad on here. This is how I personally do it. So I come around underneath, come right up, and obviously you want that through the middle limb pad if you can, but you can adjust that after you get your knot tied. And it's basically just a regular D-loop knot. And I will tighten this down usually to the outside of the limb if I can. I'll wiggle it around and make sure that knot gets really, really tight in there. And like I said, I try to keep mine on the outside of the limb. This is going to look a little bit weird. I don't want to tighten it all the way down. But I try to keep my knot on the outside of the limb. If it's underneath, that's okay. But you want to make sure that the knot is tight up against the limb. So basically get her on there. And I give it a pretty good tug down here. And obviously sits down in your rest. And this is obviously just running off the top limb. So you come down through the hole in the stopper and pull down, pull up just like this. Take your Allen wrench and tighten it down on that cord. Now you don't have to tighten that really tight. If you over tighten that, it's really gonna wear your cord down. So you just need it snug enough to hold it in the down position. This cord obviously isn't overly tight as well. Again, you want that only tight enough to hold the launcher arm in the down position. You don't need a wrench on that. You don't want it super, super tight. Obviously, you can move this quite a bit. Now, if you're running this off the bottom limb, it's going to be the same thing reversed, except you're going to come up through this part of the stopper, come through and pull it down, and then tighten the set screw. You can take the set screw out of here, put it back into here. And that's the basic setup. There's not a whole lot else to it. It's pretty simple. I showed you kind of the micro adjust on everything there. I'm gonna go through a few more things as far as the adjustment of the rest. You know, there's really no limit. I mean, there's a limit, but there is a very, very big amount of adjustment you can do with the rest. So I'm gonna do that while it's off the bow, because it's a little bit easier to show you what we got going on. But that's just the basic setup. So I will move on into the actual adjustment now.